free audio lab.
Welcome back. So in this video, I'm going to unbox an AC airCube. This is the type of airCube that is a dual band, that has a dual band 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz frequency, and it has a speed of up to 1166 plus Mbps, and this applies to the 5 gigahertz band, and it has 4 gigahertz Ethernet ports for wired connectivity, PoE passthrough for powering a 24-volt CP device powered by included power adapter or PoE, supported by UNMS software and mobile app. So this is it with airCube AC. In a short while, we'll be going through its configurations. This is how, you know, sexy it is, how beautiful. We'll try and unbox this device, and then we'll be going through its configurations as well. So I'm currently unboxing it. Wow. So this is how this device looks like. Wow, so beautiful and majestic and nice. See how it is? Let me just turn it around slowly. Wow. So these are the gigabit ports. This side is for Ethernet or the one. Okay. So I'm going to deploy this device right now, and then we'll go through its configurations for you folks to have a fair idea of how this device works. And I hope you have interest in it. So this is the reset button. In case you did a wrong configuration, you can always reset it from the button down here. Okay, so I think it comes with certain accessories as well. This is the manual that comes with it, and this is the power adapter. That's all we have in this box. It's empty. Okay. So these are the three things you can find in the box. These are the three things you can find in this box. Okay, very nice. And I guess it will have a great intuitive interface. Very great intuitive interface. I like how it is actually. It's small, it's very small. It can fit in my hand. You know, you have only this, and it serves as your CPU. Okay, as you can see, you have the 24 volt in, which means this device can be powered by 24 volt PoE, so you wouldn't have to plug any power in here, and also it can power a PoE enabled device. So I think this is the best device I've come across, which is a very good product from Ubiquiti. So please have patience, relax, and let's delve into this device and then see how it works. Okay. Now let's proceed with the configurations. So in able to configure an airCube, you need to type in the IP address of the airCube. When you type, this is what will appear. I click on advanced and then continue. Okay, that's giving us the login. The default username is UBNT Creations. So when you log in, this is the first things you are going to see. So it's asking you to select your country of preference. So in this case, I'm selecting the US as my preference country. In the US, US, where are you? Let
Let me simply use the United Kingdom, agree, and then continue. Okay, so this is my interface with regards to airCube, and immediately we are able to see the download and the upload speeds between this between the internet and the airCube. Okay, so we are able to see the 2.4 gigahertz band here and the 5 gigahertz band as well. In this case, we can proceed and do a customized configuration. So let me click on my wireless. So, I've clicked on my wireless status. AQB is active. The channel width, you can leave it at auto, or you can do a customized one. The frequency, you can do a customized selection or leave it at default. Security, you can change the password to your customized password. If we come to the 5 gigahertz band as well, the same thing applies here. You can do all your customized configurations here, and then you can proceed and save. The next thing is to check the network. This is the point where you can assign your own specific IP addresses to the LAN port. And then with aspect of the one network settings, you can decide to leave it on DHCP or static mode. But in this case, we are getting our internet from a DHCP mode, so we leave it at this way, and then it's on NAT. Then you can proceed and save your settings as well. It has a VLAN tab where you can enable VLAN and do all your VLAN configurations from here. So this is where you provide the VLAN ID and then proceed with the various configurations with regards to VLAN. But in this case, we are not dealing with any VLAN, so I leave it. Then we have the static routes. You can add a static route if you have any. You know, you are able to turn this AirCube to bridge mode as well, but then we want it in a router mode because we want to use it as a main means of bringing the internet into our homes or offices. You can do your port forwarding from this side. You can add a rule, specify the name, the port, the IP, and the destination port, and then even decide on which protocol to use, whether TCP or UDP. But we are not really doing any port forwarding stuff here. You can proceed to the system settings. You can change the device name here. You can change the username. You can change the password. You have the Ubiquiti network manager here, which is a software. You can actually have on your iOS or Android to manage these devices. You can proceed with your firmware upgrade at the maintenance tab, even reboot it from here. You can download the configurations and even do a reset of this device at this part of it. this device. I like its intuitive nature. Okay, so this is it with configuring airCube on your desktops or laptops. Now let's download its application on Android and then see how you can configure on your Android device as well.
Okay, so let me proceed and download the UNMS from my Android. So UNMS, I guess I have it on my phone already. Okay, so now it's UISP. Okay, so let me open it and then connect to the airCube's network and then proceed with the configuration. So let me type in my password, STN. From THVD9. Okay, I'm connected to it. Now let me, okay, good. I can see the airCube. So let me click and then proceed with its configurations. Let me show you guys, scan PR code. Okay, grant. So I need to scan its QR code. Okay, I've scanned it. I'm trying to log in. Okay, great. So I'm able to log in and then I can see details of this device. So internet is unavailable. Actually, I was using my phone as a main source of the internet. So you wouldn't be able to see internet connectivity at this time around. But then you can be able to see the upload and download speeds on this device. So this is the 5 gigahertz. The 2.4 gigahertz also gives us this throughput, which has an output power of 20 dBm, and the 5 gigahertz is also 20 dBm. So we currently have our access point here with the MAC address and all those. Okay, so let me check on the features here. Okay, so when we click on details, we're able to see details of upload and download, the network mode, the uptime, CPU, the time, and all those other stuff. We're able to do the configurations also from here. Okay, so if you don't want to use your desktop or laptop to configure the airCube, you can also use your mobile phone as well. It could be iOS or Android, and you could achieve the same purpose. If we go to site survey, no wireless. Okay, so we're able to survey and see other neighboring wireless access points as well. Okay, let me click on this. So basically it's able to
you can't, I don't think you can really do anything apart from the fact that you're able to see the, you're able to see your neighboring wireless access points as well. You can't really do anything. Okay. You have the backup, firmware upgrade, reboot, reset to factory default. Yeah. Okay. So this is all about AirCube router. Let me try and reset it. Okay. So it's it has locked me out and I'm no more connected to it. All right. So thanks for watching this video.